You need a guide, but Bruce.
They want aluminum.
It's pure aluminum, right? So
I think so. That's the
traction. Yeah. Wow, we're actually touching a real
thing. Does this fly?
No, not gonna fly at all.
We don't fly the jets, they say. Yeah.
It
costs, I guess.
Air, well, also museums. Air museums don't fly either. Well, they do here, I guess. But jets go too fast.
Yeah.
Too much mistakes. So you fly, then it's going straight up. So you get used to so-called
the G's,
yeah. G's per se.
What kind of plane was this?
The C-104 Starfighter. Built in the States. Canada and a lot of countries in NATO bought these things as well. We had initially six squadrons were actually in France.
How short the wing is?
Now.
Why?
Yeah. Feel this. You ought to be alike when you work in this plane. Really, really sharp.
Wow.
Sharp.
Yeah. Rage.
You slice yourself on that, it's gonna hurt.
Wow.
Now, there's no engine in this, but it does give you a kind of a sense of distance.
Wow.
This is a Voodoo, built in the United States, purchased by Canada, because we needed a to really replace the CF-100. Needed speed,
Guidance system in front.
Now, this plane carried a nuclear weapon on it. The nose of this in there, then the pilot would lock this beam here
to that
target and then flip that thing off and go right down the line. Exactly.
Yeah. Wow.
Yeah. This thing goes about 1,200 miles an hour. It had good, one of the benefits of it was it had some good range.
Right.
You could get up there in Northwest Territory, it's not waiting back and back in or something. You still have the range. Kind of sad, it's slowly deteriorating, that's what it is.
Yep.
Starfighter.
These are all like what?
T-33 Starfighter, that's what we call it. The X call it the T-80 at the end of the Second World War. They were used actually. And these things went right into the 80s as trainers. Even the tutors was only put in the books.
After
the 70s, the early 80s. Wow, this little cutie. It's an embarrassment, but that's one of her cuties.
Like Ralph Button.